So this is a typical setup for my underglaze painting stage of my work. I have my underglaze colors in front of me. I typically just lean them in front of me so I can look more directly into the colors themselves. They are powdered pigments, high temperature pigments. Can be used as low as cone 5 up to cone 13. This is my Tsinghua blue, my cobalt blue, in liquid form. I prefer the cobalt in liquid form because it's easier to work with, and plus it's the pigment is more refined, and therefore I don't get as much of the particles involved that which may distort some of the colors once you apply them. Of course, my brushes that I use in my mixing plate. My mixing plates are all ceramic plates. I prefer you not to use plastic or paper because it gives you distortions in the mix of in the wash itself that can be difficult to visualize. Because remember, we're visualizing in these colors because some of these colors will change as we fire them. So through my years of experience, I do kind of paint in a blind manner. That is, I use them as strictly as a guide because I know that the colors are gonna be a little bit different once they're fired, especially in cobalt blue. As you can see here, it's almost like a black, but when it's fired up, it comes up to a beautiful, rich cobalt color. I often put paper on my desk. Paper is easier to clean up. Can also use it for, to take water off the brush, which I'll show you in a while. This is my paper just for taking water off the brush. Loading of the brush and application of brush is very important in my painting technique, and I use the paper a lot to kind of give me as perfect a balance of water to brush as I can, which allows me to do the finer techniques in my work. I'm going to work with a small ceramic porcelain tile. This is like a maquette. That means that I use these primarily just for studies for the larger work. I don't have to work in 2 foot piece, or even a 1 foot work, which would be like 20 centimeters to say 60 to 70 centimeters. I don't need to do that because I can just work out all my ideas and techniques on the small first, just like when you use a maquette for sculpture. You use a small one first to work out some ideas and concepts. So this is what I do. Typically, just a sponge, and then what I will do is I just wipe over the porcelain to kind of take off a lot of the dust area. Now this here is bisqueware. Primarily I work on greenware on large work, but the bisqueware is a bit easier it gives me some easier ways to work with. But you know, the idea is a sgraffito, but the bisque is a little bit harder, so it's more difficult to use wooden tools, which I prefer to use because of this. I can get a better sensitivity to the work. When I'm on bisque work, I have to go to a metal tool, which is I don't like the sound and I don't like the feel of it. But for this size of work, it's okay. I'm not worried about that. So the first layer I always put down is the highest temperature of the underglaze pigment Tsinghua. The Tsinghua has to go underglaze in order to get the richness of the blue out of it. So I apply them all together in the one stage. Now the ideas can be just a process of thinking of different images. So this way I use my pencil first to give me a guide, and maybe what I'll do is I'll just use this top here to give me a guide for the opening. And this image is going to be a yin yang sign. I like to use them in different ways. I use many different images and symbols. The symbol of yin yang is very strong for me. You know, the change in our life patterns, the ever-evolving cycles of work, which Carl Jung often talks about. So to me, it triggers an image. It doesn't matter about your language or your culture. When you see the image or symbol of the yin yang, it already inspires a narrative for you. Because although I am combining these images to create my own narrative, it's important that the other people will read their own stories into my work. And that's what makes it strong for me, I believe. So then I will perhaps, maybe we're going to do a face. And I do like to work freehand as much as possible to give me, I like the freehand style because it gives me a better feel of the work. And so we'll talk about those, talk about that idea later. So often I will sketch down in pencil first. So just giving me ideas. I'm just putting a couple of ideas now. Often my composition just build by themselves, but I start with a seed of an idea and allow that seed to then grow into the flower. Remember the book, the secret of the golden flower. So the idea, the seed of the flower then grows up into a beautiful lotus. And that's what the steps that we're staging here. Then from this point, then I will go into my brushwork. Going to use a fine brush, and I'm going to put it down. I'm going to put the over the pencil. I'm going to use Jinhua, controlling the brush. So here, then I will go over these elements here. And then putting in various brush ideas, putting in some wash. And then for the yin yang sign, I'll use a little bit of color here. I'm going to use red to go around. So although the pencil itself might be very secure, aligned, then I can go over this with my brush to give it a little bit more of a random flowing feel. And I'm going to use yellow. Now this is coming into color theory, why to use yellow and red, the primary colors. And we'll talk about how that impacts the work. I may sometimes use my fingers to kind of just move over. Softens up the air, softens up the brush, and puts a little bit more shadow and feel into it. So here we are, sort of developing a pattern and an idea as the basis of my first work. Then I can come in with my sgraffito. And we can use the sgraffito in different ways. We can use different tools, you can use knives, but again, it has to be metal. And then what I would do is then go over the work. So you can tell by the sound of it, it's kind of very sort of scraping. I will go over the different parts of this, where the brush was. Again, on my fingers. And then I could create a graffiti line through it. It doesn't perhaps show up very much right now, but it's very nice, very interesting results once you fire them up. Now I have a lot of space around here, and then I would just come in with a larger brush, and I'll use this green here. I'll mix some with the yellow so it takes away. Don't often like to use just straight color. I like to use a combination of these colors together to give it more variety and more richness. Then a very wet brush, and then I can go through different parts of the work. Over the images, because these images are going to be the first layer. So I'm not concerned at this point whether they disappear or not. If there's some portion of it that I want to highlight more, then I can go in at this time. And then go back over the work. I can go over this whole surface here so I can make it more smooth and take out some of the work on it. So here we are, so sort of a first stage, a primary stage. Once I'm comfortable at this stage, then I will fire this. And then the next stage then brings in another stage. Now I may do another layer of color once it's fired at this stage, because often the firing can bring up certain defects, or I don't like the composition, I want to add something else to it. So I will do a second high temperature firing at the first phase. And we'll talk about a little bit about that the next time.